I'm in the army now. I'm on my way and how. As one of a mob that's doing a job, we're in the army now. The monkey men will soak you, Hollywood.
The monkey men will soak you, Hollywood.
They'll find it all no jokey, oh, when they get a swift kick in their Tokyo. Inky, dinky, Hollywood.
The Second World War lasted between 1939 and 1945. It involved most of the world's nations, including all great powers, organized into two opposing military alliances, the Allies and the Axis. It was the most widespread war in history, with more than 100 million military personnel mobilized. In a state of total war, the major participants placed their entire economic, industrial, and scientific capabilities at the service of the war effort, erasing the distinction between civilian and military resources. Over 70 million people, the majority civilians, were killed, making it the deadliest conflict in human history. The advent of military aviation and the development of long-range bomber aircraft during World War II made regular attacks on a large scale possible. The development of these military technologies made soldiers detached from the realities of war. More or less, pressing the button was all it took to bring almost total destruction to cities like London, Hamburg, Dresden, and many others. This is what William Hofstadter, an American pilot, wrote in a letter to home in 1944. "Dear folks, I never thought I could get so much pleasure out of doing such destructive things, but once we get airborne, there's only one thing we live for, and that's to press the button. It means one less time we have to press it before we come home." Air power in World War II undoubtedly changed the nature of war. Strategic bombing made discriminating between civilians and military targets harder, drawing attention to the ethics of war. Although civilians were not officially targeted, the war ended with a total of more than 34 million civilian casualties. James Spade, Principal Secretary of Britain's Air Ministry, discussed the ethics of civilian bombing in his book Bombing Vindicated from 1944. According to him, World War II had obscured the distinction between civilians and soldiers. In his book, he advocates the bombing of civilians involved in warlike activities. In his words, the millions of workers in military factories were considered a fair objective for airstrikes. Suddenly, the definition of military target had changed. Suddenly, war was not waged against the enemy combatant forces, it was waged against the whole population of the enemy country, since one way or another it was involved in the war effort. In the spring of 1942, 300 American B-29s laid waste to 15 square miles of Tokyo. 83,000 were killed and 102,000 were injured in the firestorms. Up to roughly that point, the bombings in Japan had leveled 2.25 million buildings, 9 million people were homeless, 260,000 were dead, and 412,000 were injured. In the summer of the same year, after dropping more than 700,000 warning leaflets, the United States dropped a uranium bomb on Hiroshima. On that day and the days following, 200,000 died. 3 days later, a second atomic bomb, this one powered by plutonium, was dropped on Nagasaki. The result? 74,000 dead. These are merely examples of the effects of strategic bombing. Many have criticized this approach to warfare as a breach in international law. Yet, the Second World War remains the deadliest war ever fought. It has proven how easy it is to erase theoretical boundaries and justify mass killings of civilians, and has shown that pressing the button is all it takes.